Hey everyone, so I'm making this little video to talk about my journey with professional laser hair removal, so let's go. I recently got this amazing Groupon deal for $99 for 8 treatments, so that's what we're doing today. That was hands down the most painful thing I've ever been through. Like, on a scale of 1 to 10, it was a 7. And when I went to the guy that I had a consultation with, he told me how it was. I'm like, it was a 7. He was like, that's really not common. So did you tell the person that it hurt? I'm like, yeah, I told her and she didn't stop. So now I'm going back to my place and I'm going to record a little bit more for today. And yeah, it's been about 30 minutes after my appointment. And I just wanted to make this topic, if you will, a series on my channel because a lot of the trans women that I followed have only really verbally talked about it and they don't show the in-depth like process of laser hair removal and how long it takes and, you know, the shaving routine and stuff. So this is going to be like a little video journal, kind of like Kat Black's video. Where she documented like her journey with laser hair removal throughout the week and how she felt about it. And yeah, I kind of want to do the same thing as her. So all credit to Kat for, you know, originating, you know, this whole concept of really vlogging and showing an in-depth look into laser hair removal. Because a lot of the girls I follow, like I said, have not shown the process. They only talk about it months or years later, like, oh, I just got laser, I got electrolysis. And it's like, well, what is your result? Like, what's the regrowth like? What's shaving like? Does the hair actually fall out? So I'm definitely going to be talking about that throughout this week. Here I am, day one, and I've only done my chin area because everything else is like manageable and I'm not as dysphoric about the other areas because it's not as visible as my chin. So yeah, here I am, first day. It doesn't hurt anymore, but it definitely did hurt like while she was lasering me and immediately afterwards, which is normal. But I wanted to talk a little bit more about my first time because it was painful and it shouldn't have been painful. I have a full sleeve of tattoos, for Christ's sake. Like, you know, I have a high pain tolerance, and this was on like on a scale of 1 to 10, like I said earlier, it was like a 7. And I only had like 10 seconds because of Snapchat, but it hurt. It really fucking hurt. Like, I have very sensitive skin, but it was, she's like, oh, it's gonna feel like wristbands snapping at your skin. And like, I kid you not, it felt like she was setting it all on fire. And it wasn't like a, it was like a, and I'm like, oh my God. And like, you can't move during a treatment. You can't talk. So I'm literally going, because like it hurt so much. It's probably the most painful thing I've ever been through, minus the time that I had a shot of penicillin shot into my ass. Like, that was by far number one. This is number two. This hurts. This is a bitch. And I know that a lot of, you know, girls are like, it's not that bad, it just hurt a little tiny bit. Like, this shit hurt. It hurt. And it says a lot because I have a high-ass pain tolerance. Oh, look at that cleavage, though. you know, like, I have a high pain tolerance, so that says something. So, just a disclaimer for girls who are trying to get laser, it hurts like a bitch. But yeah, this is probably going to be my longest day segment. The rest are probably going to be about me feeling dysphoric because I can't shave for 3 days. Which is going to be interesting. So yeah, I'll just see you tomorrow.
Hey everyone, it is day two after my laser hair removal appointment. Usually I shave my face every other day, so today, you know, the regrowth isn't anything spectacular. It's what I'm used to. I'm really nervous though because I'm going out tomorrow to see my partner, and Sunday I'm going back home on public transportation, and I can't shave until Monday because they advise that you wait 4 days after shaving. So this should be a fun fucking weekend, you know, showing up to my partner's house like, hey, I have facial hair, what's up? But it's not that big of a deal because they're also trans. But here's a closer look at my laser hair removal results. I only did it on my chin. Sorry, this is really up close and personal. I have powdered donuts on my lips. I'm so sorry, y'all. I know you can't really see it because it's my MacBook and it's not the best, but yeah, that's pretty much what my facial hair regrowth looks like. Today, again, is Friday, September 16th, and yeah, so I will see you all tomorrow. Hey everyone, it's me, Grace. Today is Saturday, September 17th. I'm feeling a little bit dysphoric today because my facial hair is making me uncomfortable, and I know it's not showing up on camera. But in real life, it's a, like, you can see the discoloration. I don't know if you can see it because I'm so pale. But, I'm really uncomfortable. I'm very dysphoric. I'm about to go to my partner's, apartment around 6. And I'm about to hop in the shower, and it's going to take everything in me not to shave my face. And like I said earlier, I can't shave it until Monday because the laser that I'm using is really strong and it's recommended that you wait 4 days until you shave. And going into that, I wanted to talk about the specific laser that, I'm getting treatment under. So I have the paperwork here for the laser center that I'm going to. And I can't remember the exact laser itself that I am having treatment under with because it's not written on here. But I got some pre and post treatment for laser hair removal instructions that I want to read out to you all. So when it comes to laser hair removal, they want you to either clip or shave the area that you're getting treated on 2 days prior to the procedure. In my case, I shaved that day because I'm not comfortable going out in public with any discoloration. It's really important to use SPF on your skin when you're opting for laser hair removal because your skin's very sensitive, it's very brittle and dry, and it's important to put, you know, moisturizer and sunscreen on it so that way you don't get any sun damage. So yeah, like I said, I cannot shave until Monday because of the fact that just got laser on Thursday. The regrowth isn't that bad. It looks way worse in person, but like, it just makes me uncomfortable to, like, it's not, it doesn't feel like hair. It just feels like very dry skin. I can't describe the feeling of my skin right now. The texture of it is really weird. But another important thing about laser hair removal is that you have to avoid shaving for 24 hours or 4 days. In my case, 4 days. And you also cannot, like, go under any, like, hot water. You can't, like, you have to avoid hot water in general. And so I'm finally gonna wash my body and stuff today because I'm seeing my partner, and yeah,
Again, today, September 17th, Saturday. And yeah, 2 days post laser treatment. I know for a fact that tomorrow will be very difficult for me because I will want to shave my face, but my partner's a good person and she will be helping me out with my dysphoria and reminding me, don't shave your face. So yeah, I'll just see you all tomorrow. Hey everyone, it's currently Sunday, September 18th. This is my third day post laser hair removal. This is too much. Yeah, this is really uncomfortable. Yesterday, like I said in the last update, I was going to my partner's apartment, and in order to do that, I had to take the MBTA public transportation system as well as the commuter rail. Hands down, the most uncomfortable feeling ever is having a bunch of Red Sox tourists gawking at me. Because, I've been medically transitioning now for 2 years, so I do pass. And that's just a reality of how I wake up, I walk out the door, I'm good, I pass, I'm safe. But yesterday, I felt how I did at the beginning of my transition, which is unsafe, scared, uncomfortable, dysphoric. A reason why I'm getting professional laser hair removal is because of the fact that I'm so uncomfortable with my facial hair. So it's been a challenge to not shave my face. Luckily enough, my partner is also trans and she understands me, she's there for me, she made me feel comfortable, and I love her forever for that. But it's hard to make a video for you all right now with like hair. It feels very foreign, but I'm starting to experience a lot of shedding. Well, not a lot, like a moderate amount of shedding. The hair definitely does not feel coarse. It feels very soft and it snaps off. Like right now, there's a bunch of hair on my bed, and that's kind of nasty. But yeah, like I said, today is September 18th. It's a Sunday. Can't wait until tomorrow so I can shave my face and exfoliate and be rid of this really gross feeling. So, yeah, I'll just see you all tomorrow for the final update. Hey everyone, today is Monday, September 19th, and it has officially been 4 days since I got laser hair removal. this is going to be the last update for my first treatment. I'm going to have a series about all 8 treatments that I'm getting. But today felt like Christmas, oddly enough. Because this entire weekend has been hard because I shave every other day. I really wanted to shave, but I knew it'd be worth it. And this morning, I was extremely hairy to the point that I was like, yeah, I need to shave. And since today's, 4 days post laser, I could. This is probably the smoothest my skin has ever been. I didn't bleed at all. Shaving itself took me like no more than 5 minutes, which is the quickest ever been, which is a good feeling. But yeah, I didn't experience shedding in the sense that like when I rub my face, nothing came off besides the dead skin. But when I actually shaved, it was like, oh shit, like one swipe would get all off. And that's usually not how my hair is. But yeah, I'm like really smooth, hair free, and I feel great so far. So, again, today is Monday, September 19th. My next laser appointment is October 20th. So, yeah. And In my next laser hair removal appointment, I'll talk about how this next month is going to be in regards to shaving, regrowth, how it looks, yada, yada, yada. So, yeah. I hope you all like this video. I hope it's educational. And until next time, bye.